Chimeraland is a recently released game that some may call an MMORPG, while others may disagree. Personally, I think it's an online RPG with MMORPG elements. In this video, I'm taking a look at the 10 things to know if you are considering playing Chimeraland. Number 1. The character creator is insane. There's 18 races available and so many sliders to make yourself super unique. But it can get really weird if you want it to. Number 2. There is no auto in this game whatsoever. Everything is purely manual play only, and I'm all for it. For me personally, this is exactly what I want in a mobile game, and I wish more games on mobile would follow this trend. Number 3. Chimeraland is a huge open world sandbox game. You truly do have complete freedom to do whatever you want. Build your house, gather for days, or hunt monsters for pets, mounts, or hide. Number 4. The file size is currently 6.19 gigabytes at time of making this video, and will continue to get bigger with updates, so keep that in mind. Number 5. There is open world PvP on the middle continent, and you can have combat on your own continent if you find an enemy faction player. This happened to me personally, and I was shocked to find an enemy faction player so close to my home. So naturally, I engaged in combat, and it was quite exciting. Number 6. If you're a home builder like me, you'll be pleased to know that there is no paywall on house building. All materials and sizes are available as a free-to-play player, and can really build a huge mansion however you want. Number 7. Monsters and critters can not only be hunted for their hide, but can also be tamed as pets and mounts. This gives you many reasons to adventure and find these wild beasts that could be a part of your mount and pet list. Number 8. Some great beasts can be soloed once you're in your 30s and above. Just make sure your gear is at least purple and have plenty of health potions. Number 9. Your companion and mount can fight alongside you. This can be handy when soloing great beasts. Your companion also can be geared as well, so don't forget to grant gear to your companion. Also, you'll find potential companions in your house. Complete their small quests to get them to join you. Number 10. When exploring the world, always remember to activate the central pillars you come across. They allow you to teleport back to their location. This will save lots of time traveling in the long run. And for the bonus round, the PC experience is vastly different from the mobile one for now. From what I've heard, there isn't enough login options for PC, and if you're wanting to cross-play the same account, the safest bet is to go log in with Twitter or your email. I myself have made an account via Twitter to allow for future gaming possibilities on PC once I am able to. Also, the optimization just isn't as good on PC at the moment. Chimeraland is primarily a mobile game first and foremost, so please keep that in mind. This could change in the future, but for now, that's the current expectations for PC use. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed my 10 things to know if you're interested in playing Chimeraland. Thanks for watching. This is Sorasyn wishing you all a great day. I do have a first impression on Chimeraland coming to MMOByte Mobile channel, so please check that out, or if it's not up yet, keep an eye out for when it does go up. Remember to subscribe and hit that bell icon, and finally, follow me on all my socials in the description and pinned comment below.